Right. In for back and chest. Starting off with rope, straight arm pull downs. I like starting with these at the moment. I either start with them or I'll finish with them, mainly just because it helps get blood into the muscle. And at the moment I'm struggling to get a pump. So if I can use this at the start, get some blood within my lats, and then go through with the session, obviously I just feel like I get a better connection with it. So if you're struggling to connect with your lats, start with this, see how you feel with it. But yeah, only gonna be doing one working set for this to start off with. Still doing 1 to 2 working sets per exercise. Obviously we've still got a competition in like 12 days, 11, 12 days, fuck knows, next Sunday. So yeah, still gotta be careful, but still training hard, still getting the job done. Let's get it. All right, going into the working set. Just a little tip with this one, is when you're getting into it, what you wanna do, you wanna drop your shoulders. A lot of people keep their shoulders up and they're like this. Literally just drop your shoulders, let your arms be pulled out, and just drive your elbows back. Keep your chest nice and high. Oh. Yeah, got Lil with me as well. Dragged her out of bed. It's 8:30, but we're training fasted at the moment. At the moment, I'm just getting up, hydrating in the morning, have a coffee, and then I'll head to the gym, train, and then if I've got cardio, I'll do cardio. So I've got 40 minutes cardio to after the session. So,
how bloody lovely.
And I've got you here to accompany me. But I can actually wear a white vest now. I'm still got the tan off on the show, so I don't look as pasty as I usually do, or as Lil does right now. Yeah. 2 working sets for this one. Right, now on wide grip cable chest supported row. You literally, yeah, when you're in prep, so like sometimes I'll do like a T-bar instead, but when you're in prep, you just avoid lifting anything that you don't need to lift. So if there's a stack machine where I can do a cable, I'm doing that. I do not want to be throwing 20 kilo plates about loading machines up, because it's just long and fatiguing for your boy. Just got one more back exercise and then move on to 2 chest. I'll do a little bit of posing and then 20 minutes cardio, and then in that cardio, gonna go. Oh, it's gone a bit fucking dark here, haven't I? I don't know. You're gonna have to deal with it. Dark samurai. But yeah, what's good? After that, oh, that's annoying me. I still gotta get used to like the lighting and all that shit on camera, because I don't really know much about it. But yeah, once I've done my cardio, gonna go over my post-show thoughts, kind of like my thoughts and feelings about the show, and then going into the show. But I'm telling you right now, I've got a fire lit in my ass to just come in my best, so yeah, yeah. And I've gone dark again. What the hell? Right, that's it for back now. Two chest, let's get it. See some titty cleavage. Ah. Shit. I forgot how good that feels. I've been like lazy recently, like not setting this up and just choosing something easier, but that felt so good. Yeah, man. Happy days. Right, we are now doing cardio. Got 45 minutes. I do it on the Stairmaster. And yeah, not too bad to be fair. All I do, yeah, is I choose a couple videos on YouTube. And I'm like, all right, these two videos, that will get me to 45 minutes. No, 40 minutes, sorry. Easy. Keeping heart rate between 130 and 150, so I kind of aim for that 140 mark. And then we go from there. Yeah, anyways, thought I would go over, obviously, show day. Actually, quickly, before I get into that, I'm gonna make a little announcement. Oh, announcement. What's it called? I am currently, officially, working with 4Ball Sports now, which I'm super excited about. They're a company that is basically just straight up bodybuilding. They have a range of the best UK brands at this current time, selling your protein, cream or ice, your EAs, creatine, glutamine, health sups, hydration sups, literally everything. And obviously a range of brands. So like, you know, you're not just stuck to having, I don't know, Perform protein, for example. You might want like a Train by JP protein. So they have like a range of supplements and they're all top. Like I use them all, even before I was with 4Ball, I was using them all. So I do truly believe in, you know, all the brands that they're selling and obviously what they stand for. And they also do blood work. They have an education platform. So like literally 4Ball Sports is just a one-stop place and that's what they want to be. And to be a part of that, I'm extremely proud and I want to represent them as to the best I possibly can. So yeah, super excited to start working with those. So yeah, if you guys want any of their supplements, please do use code O'Keefe in the checkout and get yourself 10% off. That would be greatly appreciated. But yeah, super excited about that. Haven't announced it on Instagram yet, but by the time this video goes up, I probably will have. So yeah, now into my post-show thoughts. So obviously came into the Rastrick Rumble, which is the regional qualifier. So I had to do that show to do the show that I'm doing on Sunday, next Sunday, sorry, in 12 days, which is the pro qualifier, which if you win that, you get a pro card, which obviously is like one of the expectations that like it's something that I want to work towards and it's my dream. Like my dream is to get on the Olympia stage, but to get to the Olympia stage, you have to get a pro card. So it's almost like a, you know, it's a step that I need to take and it's something that I need to achieve to get where I need to be. So it was always on the cards. And obviously the aim is to always go for that highest achievement. No point going into a show and going, oh, I'd like to get the pro card. No, we go in to put our full fucking effort into getting that pro card. So obviously went into the regional and we had to deplete up until literally from like the following Monday, no, like 2 weeks before the show, fully deplete, low carb. And then we had from 5 o'clock till 10 the next day to carb up. So it wasn't ideal, but it's what we knew we had to deal with. So we knew we wasn't going to be at our like 100% best. We knew we wasn't going to be as dry as we needed to, as full as we needed to, but we needed to make sure we made the weight cap. So we had to do what was necessary. But we stepped on stage. I was super, super, super happy with the package we brought anyways. And the standard that we went up against was incredible. Like people were saying, that regional Class B qualifier class were literally up to like a pro qualifier standard. So it was like, you know, to be able to share a stage with all the competitors that, you know, especially, so obviously shout out to Joe. He won, he looked incredible, was absolutely peeled to the fucking bone. And then a guy called Sam came second, looked amazing. And obviously I came third. I'm not too sure about the other people in the class, exactly on their placings, but everyone looked incredible. So yeah, the standard was just fucking insane. And to be able to, you know, place third in that lineup, I was extremely proud. So over the fucking moon. But yeah, obviously you guys will have seen the show day video by now. If you haven't, go watch it. I hope it's a banger. I haven't edited it yet, but hopefully it's a banger. But yeah, nah. Obviously, we've now got, well, obviously now we have until next Sunday to go into our next show, where now we've made weight, we are not super stressed about having to do a load of low carb to get us down to the stupid, like to deplete us completely. Weight, we're still above the weight cap right now. So 197 pounds this morning, the weight cap is 194. But that was after, so we stepped on stage at about 192 pounds. And after having the cheat meals on the night and the day after, we had a high day, we stuck on a bit of weight. So we're just getting that off now. But a lot of that is just water and just kind of food weight. So we ain't stressing, because my condition and my look is actually better than it was. So all we're thinking is okay, if our plan is to bring us down to about one, either high 80s or very low 190s, and hopefully that should bring us that fucking grainy dry look, and then we'll also be able to kind of load up into the show. And then Friday we check in for our weight, so we register, and then we've got 2 days to fill up. So all going well, we should have, you know, I should be bringing the best look I possibly can. Very peeled, very full, and we're gonna go at it with our best. And that's all we can do. And, you know, whether we win or not, I of course I wanna win. I'm going there to fucking win. But, like, if I'm being totally honest, I just love this sport and I wanna compete. And I've only been doing this, obviously I've been going to a gym and I've competed, it's my second time competing, but you know, I haven't actually, like, I'm not seasoned in this game. That was my second ever show and I haven't competed. Last time I competed was like nearly 2 years ago. And you know, this time I was enhanced, so it's totally different prep. So, you know, it's very fresh to me, different federation, but obviously now, so yeah, like, I just want to go in there, see where I'm at compared to the people where I need to be at, and then after that we'll probably look to go into an off season, put on the size that is necessary, and then come back next year hopefully and finish it off. But I don't want to talk about next year because we've still got the show in the next 2 weeks and I can't fucking wait. Super excited for it. But yeah, those are my post-show thoughts. The only thing, one of the main things I want to work on for the next show is smiling, because as you will have seen, I look like an absolute miserable twat on stage. I was having a good time. I think the lights are so bright and backstage it's quite like intense. You know, everyone's going up and ready, pumping up. Yeah, it was quite intimidating. So like when you get on the stage, you're like, fucking game time. That's all I was thinking. So I kind of want to, for this next show, I want to be a bit more present, want to smile, and yeah, I want to show that I fucking love this stuff. So yeah, man, those are my post show thoughts. Yeah, anyways, that's 10 minutes of cardio done. Lovely. And I'll leave it there. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Obviously we've got peak week next week, so I'll get a couple of videos out then. And then we've got another show day video coming, so hope you guys look forward to that. Honestly, I'm loving the YouTube at the moment. I'm loving doing it. So all the support that I'm getting, I appreciate it, honestly. It didn't go unnoticed. And I'm gonna keep doing it. I love it. So yeah, man, anyways, hope everyone has a good rest of their day. If you could do me a favor, like, subscribe, share, tell a friend, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.